Hello and welcome to NewsClick. There is nothing that drives us more than standing in solidarity with the people's movements. Our teams are on the ground covering these movements extensively and hoping to bring out a change. In this segment, we bring you a roundup of various such protests and movements that have taken place across the country over the past few weeks. Manipur has been witnessing protests against the Naga Framework Agreement and extension of the Article 371A in the state. The framework talks about the special status that is to be accorded to the Nagas. The pact was signed to settle the demand for the creation of a separate Nagalim comprising of Naga inhabited areas of Manipur, Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. Protesters believe that this move will lead to the creation of a state within a state, as one community may be benefited against the interest of the other. The opposition has repeatedly termed the move as a ploy by the centre government to divide the state. Women have been at the forefront of the protests, with many businesses being shut down across the state to show support. Various sit-in protests were staged, while many auto drivers also halted their daily services and protested at their parking lots. Students from Jawaharlal Nehru University had issued a call for a protest march in Delhi towards the Home Ministry following the Kerala floods. The students had hoped to create pressure on the central government to do more to contribute towards the relief measures in the state and declare it as a national calamity. However, the bus full of students trying to reach the Home Ministry was halted. The police compelled the students to deboard the bus and even beat some of them while detained many. Close to 100 local trains have been cancelled in the past 4 days following a strike by the motormen and rail workers in Mumbai. Backed by the Central Railway Mazdoor Sangh and several other unions, the guards and Central Railway workers have refused to work overtime. The protesters have been urging the administration to fill up the vacancies. And not only that, as per reports, the average daily duty cannot exceed more than 6 to 7 hours, while the guards and motormen say that they are made to work for more than 10 hours. Students of the Presidency University in Kolkata are up in arms against the administration after it failed to shift them from a temporary hostel that is located at a distance of 18 kilometers from the campus to Hindu Eden Hostel, which is the one that stands right next to the campus. Citing inhabitable conditions at the hostel, the students have transformed the corridor outside the Vice Chancellor's office into a dormitory and are demanding an immediate transfer to the Hindu Eden Hostel. That's all for this week. To follow detailed reports on these protests and movements, please visit our website and our Facebook page. Thank you.